Yo guys, what's up? Another step in the unveiling of all the Star Wars Battlefront 2 mysteries, with three new planets to complete the map selection of this galaxy. Kamino, Starkiller Base, and the ice planet of Hoth, that offers a unique wildlife selection. But first up, Kamino, and I gotta say that the outdoor part of this map looks extremely beautiful. The inside area reminds me of a Black Ops 3 DLC map. But like every gamer knows, Black Ops 3 has been dead and buried for 14 months by now. Nothing but boosters and cheaters remain, so Zombies Chronicles is the only positive thing left to do on that game. But I don't see anything wrong with Kamino. It's a great setting, and it must be very sad and hurtful for Infinity Ward to see that EA managed to create something that perfectly combines esports movement with old school movement. That's gotta sting for them. I guess Activision had plans to create the same kind of atmosphere, but Call of Duty is just too much of a personal competition to go into space themes. We as a community would rather keep playing with boots on ground soldiers rather than going to space. The next map is my least favorite one. It's called Starkiller Base, and my only dislike towards this map goes to the layout, with a couple of large hangars that are connected via a series of hallways and staircases. But seeing that EA wants to recreate the actual setting, I have no other problem with Starkiller Base. By using the heavy class, you can deploy a turret at a certain choke point so you can attack the targeted enemies from two different positions, but do your best to stay away from the heroes and villains because they require multiple reloads before they finally go down. The specialist weapons, the snipers, they're pretty difficult to use and also require the proper settings. But if you like maps like Kill House and Nuketown, you will enjoy Starkiller Base and its kill crazy atmosphere. Everyone knows what a walker is, and you can ride along with it. However, its guns only have a very limited range, so enemies need to be directly in front of you if you want to target them. Again, not easy to do because the guns have a very low fire rate. Nevertheless, the remaining planet of Hoth looks very nice, but has very long and open lines of sight. An elevated position combined with an assault or specialist class weapon can get you a hero or villain very fast. Now, I also mentioned the wildlife before, and if you have ever ridden a horse on Battlefield 1, you immediately recognize the same movement with this space horse. It's very hard to shoot enemies while you're riding, and if you know the large amount of ammo it takes to get enemies down, you can figure the rest out yourself. So I took the liberty of demonstrating it, and if you think that this looks bad, believe me, it takes a long time and a lot of technical know-how to master the unique shooting system of Star Wars Battlefront 2. What an epic struggle that was. The planet of Hoth is featured in the fifth movie called The Empire Strikes Back, even though I read that this game only contains parts of The Last Jedi and The Force Awakens. The best tactic is to get a reinforcement and to hang back for a little while, rather than going into full bonsai mode. The longer you stay alive and get kills and assists, the sooner you can upgrade to a hero or a villain. Rey Kenobi was that one that just passed by. From that point on, do the exact same thing and try to target a small group of enemies that are taking fire from your teammates. The more you go into bonsai mode, the sooner your reinforcement will die. Overall, following these simple rules and frequently putting up your turret can get you more than 15,000 points easily in Galactic Assault. I've seen people with more than double that amount just because they cash in on reinforcements and turrets. So it's defo a smart and efficient way to exploit the chances that are given to you. Next time we're gonna join the Air Force and discover the Forest of Endor that surrounds the military base. Flying is very difficult. Getting shot is a lot easier. I'll see you on the next one, and don't forget to have a Merry Christmas weekend. Peace.